Hey guys, it's Joni from SimpleLivingMama.com, and today I wanted to take you along and show you how I do monthly meal planning. It's just a simple way to make sure that you get the right ingredients when you go to the grocery store, and yeah, it's easier just to get it all knocked out in one sitting rather than trying to plan a weekly menu or just not planning a menu at all. So yeah, I'm gonna turn the camera around and show you what I am doing for the month of April. So here is my monthly meal plan sheet. This comes from my book, which is all about once a month grocery shopping. And I just print one out every month and then sit down and figure out what we're going to eat. I don't strictly plan breakfast and lunches, but I do have like a loose idea of what we're going to eat for the month. This month, I know that on Fridays we always have pizza, so that's easy. I don't have to think about what we're going to eat on Friday nights, and I kind of get a break from having to cook anything. On Tuesdays, we like to have what's called Taco Tuesdays. And sometimes I make tacos, sometimes I make fajitas, just anything that's like Mexican related. So we are already into the second week of April now, so I do not need to plan anything for this week. We were gone over Easter weekend and we just kind of had a reset week last week. All right. So on Tuesday, I think I'm going to plan tacos. And then on this Tuesday, I found a recipe in this book, the Trim Healthy Table book, which I am slowly trying to get back on the Trim Healthy Mama diet plan. And this book has a lot of neat recipes in it. So there was one recipe that I found in here that I wanted to try, and I think it was like the fajita skillet. So I am going to plan that for this Tuesday, the 17th. And then on the 24th, I think I may do a soup, like an enchilada soup. Now normally, I would base my meal plan off of my inventory, what I already had on hand, but we just recently moved into this house and I don't really have a stock in anything. Everything that we have already bought, I had cooked up, so I'm pretty much meal planning from scratch. But I would definitely look in your freezer, see what meat that you already have available. Check in your pantry, see what you already have available, and base your meal plan off of that. Okay, so I've got Tuesdays done and Fridays done. I like to do crock pot meals, and I like to do easy, like, casserole skillet meals. So what I'm going to do is I have created a master list of meals. That's here on my iPad. These are breakfast ideas, lunch ideas, and snack ideas. And then things that we like to bake. And then dinner ideas. So I know one night, it's not on here, but I saw a recipe for tuna mac in the Trim Healthy Mama book. So I want to do that one night. I'm just gonna pick a Wednesday. I also found some recipes online I can show you. Here we go. Let's see, there were two that looked really good. Some chicken cordon bleu casserole. We really love chicken cordon bleu and this one looked really good. So I think that might make a pretty good Monday meal. So we're gonna do chicken cordon bleu recipe out. I'm going to keep it saved up here on my computer. And there was another one that I had on here as well. This is meatball casserole. So a Parmesan meatball casserole. That would go good on this Wednesday. Okay. And I am thinking spaghetti is just easy, no brainer. I'm gonna write that one down on this Wednesday. And let's see what else I have on my list, if I have anything looks good off of my regular list. Salmon patties, I haven't made that one in a while. That one is an easy recipe as well. So I'm gonna do salmon patties. And what I am doing is I am just strictly planning dinners. I will fill in with vegetables. There are certain vegetables I always keep on hand, frozen broccoli, frozen green beans, frozen medley. I keep canned vegetables on hand as well, like corn, green beans, peas, stuff like that. And then when I actually go to do my shopping, I will see what's on sale and what's in season as far as vegetables go and get those for my fresh veggies. So like last week I got asparagus and I get Brussels sprouts, stuff like that. So once I actually go and do my grocery shopping and fill those in for each meal. So let's see what else we've got. Oh yeah, I wanted to do chili one night. It's April here and it feels like winter has come back. Chili is a really good like Sunday meal. My husband likes to make that with me. So chili and cornbread. We always have to have cornbread with that one. Let's see, I'm going to look over here. I love having just regular chicken. I use some Montreal chicken seasoning and season chicken breast and then cook it in the oven and it's super easy. Don't really even... It's super easy and you don't even really have to think much about it. So, let's see. I'll put it here. Montreal chicken. Let's see. On Saturday, I think I'm just going to leave these days open for leftovers or for eating out because I know what's inevitably what's going to happen is during the week something's going to come up and I may not get to cook one of these meals, and then what I'll do is we'll just have leftovers and then I can move that meal that was planned for that day over to Saturday, or if not, we can just figure out what we're going to eat on Saturday. Also, Saturday is supposed to be like our family fun day when we go out, so if we're already out, we may just eat out those days. Okay, now I'm going to look through this cookbook and see if I can get some more inspiration to finish filling in. I like to cook something decent and nice on Sundays. So try to find something, some good family meals to cook on Sundays, and then figure out what I'm going to do on, I need to fill in one more Monday and then Thursday. And I think I'm going to make Thursday crock pot day. So I'm going to look for crock pot meals in my cookbook. And yeah, I'll get back to you when I get it filled in. Okay, so I have my entire month's worth of dinners filled in, and what I added the good grub from the Trim Healthy Table, chili pie, chicken spaghetti, and the teriyaki beef, and a couple of other things like the stew of love, and It's called cracked chicken. This is actually a recipe that's on my vlog that I'm going to make Trim Healthy Mama Friendly for myself. But my family really loves this recipe. And on my blog, I think I just call it like creamy ranch chicken or something. It's good. So anyway, yeah, I've got the entire month's menus planned out. What I'm going to do for our breakfast and lunches is just make sure that I have things on hand. Like we like to eat oatmeal for breakfast a lot. Make sure I have eggs, sausage. The kids for lunch, I like to get them, it's not really the healthiest, but they really like just quick microwave burritos or corn dogs, and we'll have those occasionally. So I keep those on hand, and sandwich stuff, and then of course leftovers for lunch is always acceptable. Stuff like that. So when I go through and I make my grocery list, which I'm about to talk about, I have a master grocery list here for once a month grocery shopping. And this is like my own personal, these are the things that I like to keep on hand, even though it has kind of changed, especially with my new diet plan that I've got going on. But this is everything that I like to have for the month. So what I will do is I will go through and I will say, okay, do I need to get more of this? And then I will transfer it over to my actual list. And once I make my entire list, which I will have to look at all my recipes, make sure I have all the ingredients for all of the recipes. But once I do all of that, then I will start working on my online orders. And since we just moved to a town that has an Aldi, I think what I'm gonna do, I've already done a Sam's Club order for the things that I know that I get at Sam's Club, which once I go and pick it up, I will also do a haul video so you can see what we get from Sam's for the entire month. Anyway, I think what I'm going to do before I do a Walmart order for the month is I'm going to go hit up Aldi and see what I can find there. So I'm going to make my list of all the things that I need to get that I didn't already get from Sam's Club. And go to Aldi, get that, and then go come back home and do a Walmart online order and just go and pick it up. I love the online order stuff. It makes life so much simpler, especially when you have a large family. And if you don't already know, we are a family of eight. All of my kids are 9 years old and younger, so I don't have a lot of big eaters. My older kids are starting to eat quite a bit more, but you know, it's not like I'm having to feed all teenagers yet or anything. So as you can see, I already started up here on, like, I know, okay, over the course of the entire month, we're probably gonna go through about 16 gallons of milk. I will not get this all at once. What we do is we typically get 4 to 8 gallons, and then when we need to get more, we will do like a, mid-month grocery shopping trip, and we'll get more milk and more cheese and more eggs and stuff. Also, I like to have creamer. That's not Trim Healthy Mama, but I like my creamer in my coffee. So we go through about 4 containers of that every month. Butter, eggs. This is a conservative estimate. I am gonna start boiling eggs for snacks. So yeah, and all these recipes look like they're gonna be calling for eggs too. So we're probably gonna be going through more than 8 dozen eggs, I'm sure. We also like to drink orange juice, and I don't buy a ton of that. It's more like a treat type thing. So we get 2 jugs for the entire month. I'm not buying crescent rolls or cinnamon rolls anymore. And the kids aren't really crazy about ham and cheese sandwiches. So I'm probably not gonna get cheese slices. But yeah, everything else on this list I do get, and I've got it all planned out. The yogurt, the cheeses, and let's see what else. I think that's it on this list. Are coming from Sam's, and everything else will come from the other grocery stores. Now down here, I actually already have most of these ingredients, and I also, since I'm starting back on Trim Healthy Mama, I've got some other like sugar substitutes that I ordered from Amazon that I'm gonna be using just mainly in my stuff. And I also might try some of the recipes like for the Trim Healthy Mama desserts. I haven't decided yet, but it might be a good idea for me to add to my list. Just a couple of desserts to keep on hand when those cravings for sweet things hit. But yeah, I have almost all of the stuff except bread flour, and I'm not entirely sure I'm ready to start baking bread again. Like I said, we recently moved, and I don't know. I don't know if we're gonna bake any bread this month. More sugars and stuff, we don't need those. Cocoa powder, yes, we will need some brownie mix. The kids like to bake brownies, so I can get brownie mix for them. Pancake mix and muffin mix, and then oats, which I actually had listed in another section. But yeah, we will probably get some more. We will definitely get some more oatmeal because that's like my main breakfast. And a couple of the kids like to eat it as well. All of these, I've already gone through and started a list of the things that we need to get out of these condiments. More oatmeal. I'll get the kids cereal just to have on hand as a treat. I'm getting brown rice. I got the kids macaroni and cheese. My oldest son likes to cook it, so I will get more spaghetti for the kids, and I think I'm gonna do spaghetti squash for me. So everyone else can have the spaghetti noodles and I'll have the spaghetti squash. And then here are all the meats that I like to keep on hand. So yeah, that's everything I still need to stock up on, because I got the chicken breast. I did not get a whole chicken this time from Sam's. I did get chicken breast and I got ground turkey, but I'm gonna need to add a couple of things. I'll have to see if I can get them from Walmart. Produce, this is something that we will also get halfway through the month if need be, because these are our snacks. And then like the tomatoes and the hearts of romaine and romaine lettuce, I use that a lot for just making salads for our meals. But yeah, we always have these on hand. Here are my spices, oils, and herbs that I like to have on hand. I don't think I need anything else. Don't need to add anything else to that list. Canned goods. Bread and snacks. I definitely recommend making a master list like this, so that way when you do begin making your grocery list, you know, I don't know if you're like me, but when I sit down and I'm trying to make a grocery list, like my mind just goes blank and I'm like, I don't even remember what we need. When you have something like this to refer back to, it's very, very helpful. And making sure that you get everything the first time. So frozen items, I do keep a bag of chicken nuggets on hand. I'm not getting any frozen pizzas this time. We're not going through those right now. And I've added some other things that I need to write on here. Like I am getting the frozen rice cauliflower, and I really love the sugar snap pea stir fry mix too. So I need to add a couple of things to this and just update it. But yeah, this thing is a lifesaver when it comes to actual making your list for the grocery store. So I will refer to this, and then I will refer to these, especially these new recipes that I'm not familiar with from the Trim Healthy Table Cookbook, and write down all of the ingredients that I need to get for those. Okay, so I have finally finished filling out my monthly shopping list. What I did was I went through my master grocery list, picked out all the things that I knew that I needed to buy this month, and then put them over here. And I have it divided by types of produce, dairy, meat, grains and canned foods, snack type stuff, and then freezer foods. After I did that, I looked at my recipes and I just looked to see which ingredients that I knew that we didn't have, and I put everything over here. I didn't put all the things down that I got from Sam's because, like I said, I have a set amount of things that I get from there and things that I know that I'm going to get from there, and I already did all of that. So this is just the stuff that I'm going to get from the regular grocery store. Yeah, it took me probably about, I would say 30 to 45 minutes to do all of this. But it's great because once it's done for the entire month. And I don't really have to think too much about our food, except for when we do that that stock up haul about halfway through the month. I don't have to think about anything else. So yeah, if you have a large family or you you don't like going to the grocery store very much, because I sure don't, this is a great way to just get it all over with. I will add in some more snacky stuff. I'm gonna get the kids like some granola bars, maybe some Nutri-Grain bars or something like that. I haven't quite decided yet, but I will go ahead and add a few more things to the snack pile. Of course, they always have like string cheese, yogurt, and then whatever we have as far as fruit goes for snacks. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Sorry about the shakiness of the video because I don't have my tripod right now, so I had to kind of film everything while holding the camera. But if you like this video and you'd like to see more grocery hauls or monthly meal plan videos, just to see how other people do this kind of stuff, go ahead and like this video, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe so you don't miss any more. And I will talk to you next time. Bye.